Students, this is the ninth chapter, that is string manipulation. String manipulation in Java. This is the first part of this chapter. So in this chapter, we are going to cover all this, that is string class and methods of string class, that is the functions of string class. The following string class methods to cover, that is string trim off, string to lowercase of, to uppercase of, int length of, character at, index of, last int. So these are the functions. Here in this reduced syllabus, they are asked only the syntax of these functions and the purpose of these functions and the working examples with output. So I think they are not going to ask the programs in this chapter string handling in Java. Okay, they are asking us to study only the syntax, purpose and working examples with output, but we are going to solve the exercise also. So if they ask, then we are ready to answer the questions. So the ninth chapter we are going to see, that is called string manipulation. So what is called as a string? String means it is a sequence of characters. Sequence of characters means that is a group of characters that is enclosed within double quote. It is not only the characters, it is the combination of characters and letters, that is alphabets and alphanumeric characters also. If that is a group of characters and letters that is enclosed within a double quote, or it is a group of characters enclosed within double quote, or if a group of alphanumeric values, that is digits, that is enclosed within double quote, then it is called as a string. For example, computer is a valid string constant, and just C, that is enclosed within a single quote, is called a valid character constant. Character means single alphabet that is enclosed within a single quote. Okay, so in Java, string constants are enclosed within double quotes and character constants are enclosed within single quote. So for example, in Java, if we need to store a string constant computer using a variable of string class, you can write it in this form, that is data type is string and you have to give one variable, any one variable, that is a, b, x, y, whatever it may be. Here it is taken as s. So first you have to write the data type string, then next one is the variable name, and then next one is what is the string. Okay, here s is the variable of string class that is assigned the value computer. Okay, so the computer string is stored inside the variable s. Every character of the sequence of characters that are stored in the variable s is represented by its index or position. So c is in one position, o is in one position, m is one position, p, u, t, e are all the alphabets are having some positions. Okay, it is called as index. Index numbers. Okay, so the index of the first character will start from 0. The address of the first character start from 0. Okay, the index or positions of the first character in a string is always 0, the next character is 1, and next character is 2, and so on. The following illustration shows the index or positions of the characters in the string variable s. So, string variable s consisting of the characters c, o, m, p, o, t, e, r. That is a string. So, each and every individual letters are called as characters. Okay. So, what is the position? What is the index of c? 0. What is the index of o? 1. What is the index of E? 6. What is the index of P? That is 3. So it will start from 0. okay, the first characters index is start from 0. The next one is, a string is a class that is defined in the java.lang package. Then string constants are enclosed within double quotes. Then we are going to find the if, we are going to find the length of the string. So what is called as the length of the string? That is means how many characters are present inside the string variable. That is, the length of the string is the number of characters contained in it. The length of method can be used to obtain it. The following example illustrate this. String s is equal to computers. Okay, so what is the length? That is int len. Len means length. Length equal to s dot length of. So s is the string. So what is the length of the string stored in the variable s? So the index of the string start from 0, but the length of the string will start from 1. Okay, so c is in one first, o is the second character, m is the third character, p is the fourth character, u is the fifth character, and t is the sixth character, e is the seventh character, r is the eighth character, and s is the ninth character. So how many letters are here? There are 9 letters. So the length of the string is 9. Okay, so index or the address will start from 0 and the length will start from 1. The length of method of a string returns the number of characters in a string. So the next one is concatenation. So concatenation means joining of two strings together. Okay, joining of more than one string together is called concatenation. So you have already seen a bit of concatenation process done with plus in the system.out.print method. The concatenation of strings can also be done in string variables. For example, here three string variables we used, s1, s2, s3. So string 1 is first string, string 2 is second string. So we are going to add two strings in and stored in the variable s3. So what is first string? First string, then in between we have to add the word and the second string is second string. Okay, so your output will be displayed like this in the variable s3, first string and second string. Okay, so concatenation means joining the strings together. The next one is joining of two strings is called concatenation. You can either use the plus operator to join two strings or use concate. The function name is concate. Concate of function is used to add two strings together. This concat of method to join two strings. The next one is you can concatenate the value of any data type with a string, and resultant is always a string. So whatever you joined by using the function concat of, the resultant value also a string. The next one is character data type. Okay, character means if any alphabets that is enclosed within single quote. Okay, a character data type is used to represent a single character. A string is a group of characters. A character literally is always enclosed within a single quote. For example, char, that is the data type, and x is the variable, and the value, the character a is stored in the variable x. So a is enclosed within single quote. Notice the declaration of variables x, which has been initialized with the character a. Since Java follows the unique code system of representing characters in the memory, it occupies 2 bytes of memory space. If it is possible to represent 65,536 characters in Java. Now we are going to see the table here, that is Unicode system. So the following table stores the different Unicodes for capital letters and small letters and digits. Okay, so these characters, if we are using the character A to Z, the corresponding Unicode value, that is the numerical value, is 65 to 90. If it is small a to z, it is from 97 to 122. If we are using the alphanumeric values 0 to 9, it is from 48 to 57. Okay. Now, a character constant consisting of a single character enclosed within single quote. You can use also the here also in string also, if you want to compare any conditions, we are using relational operators. Okay, you can use relational operators for comparison with characters. Next, comparison with characters. Okay, then characters when passed to a method called dialogue of blue jay should be enclosed within single quote. String should be enclosed within double quote. Ye bar bar repeat ho rahi hai. So if when you are executing a program, it will ask any characters. Okay, so it will ask for the input for characters. So when you are entering the characters, it should be enclosed within single quote. You have to be put the single quote symbol. So if it is asking for any string, you have to write the string in between double quote. Okay, next, you can increment or decrement a character to get the character before or after it. Next one, equalization of strings. That is, two strings are there. That is, the equals of method compare the characters in a string and check whether the two strings are equal or not. If the two strings matches, it returns true, and if it does not match, it returns false. The following example will illustrate. See, the first string is computer. All the letters are capital letter. It is enclosed within double quote. The second string also computer. All the letters are capital letters and it is enclosed within double quote. So the condition is if S1 dot equals of S2. So S1 and S2 are equal or not. See, here also computer. Here also computer. Here all the letters are in capital letters. Here also all the letters are in capital letter. So they are equal. So if it is equal, then they'll ask you to print the message equal. If it is not equal, then you have to print the result as not equal. So if the condition is not there, then you have to write true or false answer. Okay. So if they are both are equal, then you have to write true. If any difference is there, even in the case, you have to see the capital letter or small letter. This also you have to check. If anything is different, then you have to write false. But here they given the conditions. If string S1 is equal to S2, then you have to print equal. Otherwise, you have to print not equal. Here both are equal, so you have to write equal. This is because the both the strings S1 and S2 are equal. Okay. Now we are going to see the equals of versus equal to equal to. So equal to equal to means the left hand side is equal to right hand side. The equals of and equal to equal to operator performs two different operations. As just explained, the equals of method compares the characters inside a string. Object. The equal to equal to character compares two object references to see whether they are referred to the same instance or not. Okay, here the sample program is here. The string S is hello and ST is the new string of S1. So the characters present in the string S2 also same as that of the string S1, but it is equal, but it is same or not, it is not a problem. Then S3 equal to S1. We are storing the same value from S1 to three. Okay, so the first is S1 dot S1 dot equals S2. Kyunki yahan pe same number of characters string will be stored, so it is true. Then next one is S1 equal to equal to S2. Both the strings are equal or not. Whether it is equal, sometimes it is equal, sometimes it is not equal. We don't know, so it is false. Then S1 dot equals of S. So all the means it is true. That is all the same value will be present in string S3 and the string S1. The next one is S1 equal to equal to S3. Okay, S1 is equal to equal to S3, so it is also true. Next, the equals ignore case of function is used to check for equality between two strings. Ignore the case. Equal ignore case means whether it is capital letter or small letter, no problem. String 1 consisting of capital letter, for example, the string is hello, so all the letters are in capital letter, and string 2 consisting of all the letters are small letters, but the letters are equal, we are able to ignore the case. Okay, so if the letters are equal, it will return the true value. If the letter different, then it will return the false value. The next one is changing the case of characters within a string. That is, to change the characters, we have to use two uppercase of, two lowercase of. Two uppercase of means the given value is in lower small letters, you have to convert it into a capital letter. Two uppercase of function works like that. Two lowercase of means the given string is in small letters and you have to convert it into uppercase. Okay. So this is the two methods are available in Java to change the characters case of a character. The method two lowercase or converts all characters in the string from uppercase to lowercase. The two uppercase of method converts all characters in a string from lowercase to uppercase. Non-alphabetical characters such as digits are unaffected. The following program illustrates the use of these methods. So here we are using the string S1, computer, then upper, lower, so okay, then upper equal to, these are the variables, S1 equal to computer, then another one variable upper and then lower. Upper equal to S1 dot 2 uppercase of, so we are going to convert the string S1 to uppercase, all the letters into capital letters. Lower equal to S1 dot 2 lowercase of, we are converting all the characters into lowercase. System dot out dot println of in capital equal to upper. In next one is system dot out dot println of in small equal to lower. So the first output is in capital equal to computer, all the letters are capital. Second output in small equal to computer, all the letters are in small. So the two uppercase of method is used to convert all the characters in a string to capital letters. The two lowercase of method is used to convert all the characters in a string to small letters. Okay, then searching string. Okay, so here we are going to use the function index of and last index of, the first index of. Okay, so index of means that is the address of the string. Okay, so index of and last index of methods can be used to search for a substring or a character. The index of searches for the first occurrence of the characters or substring, and last index of searches for the last occurrence of a character or substring. Both these functions return the index position at which the character or substring is found. If a character or substring is not found, it returns minus 1. Okay, so let us see one example. Index of functions, string x is equal to siligiri. Okay, so system dot out dot println of s dot index of I. You are going to write the index of I. Here two i's are there. Okay, that is siligiri. S is in z position, I is in the first position, L is in the second position, next I is in the third position. So here 0 1 0 1 2 3 4 5 6 7. So I is in the first position, third position and the seventh position. Will display 1 at the first occurrence of the character I is in the position 1. So if you are giving only index of, it will take the index of the first occurrence of the character. Okay. Next one is system dot out dot println of index of I comma 2 will display the third will display 3. मतलब I second time कहाँ पे आ रहा है उसका index लिखना. So 0 1 2 3. Here 3 is the answer. Will display 3 as the first occurrence of I from second onwards as 3. Then s dot index of e. So here any index is there? No. No letter e is present, so it will display minus 1. Will display minus 1 as the character e is not present. Okay. Then system dot out dot println of index of the string lig. L-I-G. So, okay, it will display 2 as the substring lig occurrence from the beginning of the position 2. See, 0, 1, 2. So, it will lig, that is a group of characters. They are asking the position for that string. Okay, so L is start in the second position. So, the answer is 2. Okay, the next one is system dot out dot println of index of lig comma 4. So the fourth position we are not able to see the word lig, right? So the answer is minus 1. Will display minus 1 as there is no occurrence of substring lig from the position 4 onwards. Then let us see how last index of function works. Okay, so here it is s dot last index of I. So the last index of I means last character I. Here one I is there, here one I is there. This is the last I. So the position is in the seventh position. So we will display 7 as the first occurrence of I from right to left as if the position is 7. Then last index of I comma 6 will display 3. So I comma 6, 6 position, no I is there. We have to take from the position 0 to 6. So where is the last index? It is in the third position. So 3 is the answer. Okay. Next, the index of and the last index of methods are used to determine the index of characters or substring in a given string. So this table is very important. You have to learn all the functions. Length of, it is used to find the length of the characters in the given string. Here the example is there. Then character at of I, in which position they asked, it is here. Then substring extracts the character S to E. Okay. So here, then substring of this. Next, index of C. It is used to search the character C or string C and return the index. So the example is here, three examples they have given. Then index of C comma P, then last index of C. Okay, so these are the examples, these are the review of the chapters. Recapitulation: two uppercase of, to convert the string to uppercase of, two lowercase of, to convert the string to lowercase of, then replace C comma T. So you are going to replace the letter C and put the letter D there. Then A equals of B, equal ignore case. Then A start with B. Okay. The next function is A ends with B. Then trim off. Trim off means it is used to remove all leading and trailing spaces. Okay. So here, see computer, then there is some space, then it is the double quote is closing. So trim off means aage piche ka jo bhi wahan pe blank spaces ko hata deta hai. So the answer is computer. There is no space after R. Then a dot comparative is used to lexicographically checks two strings whether Unicode differs. Okay, that is, its return type is integer. Okay, students, So this chapter is over here. In the next part, we are going to see the question answers and some sample programs also I solved for you. Here they are asking you to study the syntax and the syntax and the working examples of the given functions. I don't know that the programs will come or not. So we will solve some programs also in part 2 of this.